So let's discover together some uses of faire faire. So faire faire is a funny expression. It's quite useful. And well, the main concept about faire faire is that someone else is doing the job, is doing it for you. Okay, so I will give you some sentences and try to make it as clear as possible. And well, obviously, we'll start with the present tense. So let's see now. Well, this sentence. So if you say, I repair my bike, my bicycle, je répare mon vélo. Okay, so in that case, you are doing it. Okay, but if you want to say that someone else is doing that for you, so it's possible in that case to have this structure. So the way to construct it is quite simple. You will first put faire. Obviously, you have to conjugate it. So je fais. In that case, we use the present. So je fais. Then the verb. We use the verb one more time. So réparer. You should put that at the infinitive because it's the second verb. Okay. Je fais réparer. And then you continue, mon vélo. And by constructing this structure, you have this concept of I have my bike repaired. So you're not doing it, but someone else is doing it for you. Okay? So let's see other sentences now. Je lave mes vêtements. So I wash my clothes. Je lave mes vêtements. So in the same way, you can express this concept of having someone else doing it for you. Je fais laver mes vêtements. So you can see, same structure, you put faire, you conjugate it, and then you put laver at the infinitive. Okay, I have my clothes washed. Je fais laver mes vêtements. So I build my house. Je construis ma maison. And so in the same way, we will put faire. After that, we put the verb at the infinitive, construire. Okay, so I have my house built. Je fais construire ma maison. Oups, sorry, I went too fast. So let's explore now la forme négative. So let's see how it goes if you want to put the negative form. So if you want to express the same sentence that we had, but at the negative form, so I don't have my house built. And so you can see that, as usual, the negative form will impact the first verb, so the one conjugated. So je ne fais pas, and then after that you can continue your structure, infinitive form, construire ma maison. Je ne fais pas construire ma maison. So let's see now if we use this passé composé, so the compound past tense. And so look how it will go. So I had my house built. J'ai fait construire ma maison. So, I mean, technically, the only thing that you need to put at this passé composé is the verb faire. Okay, and so the verb faire at the passé composé will become j'ai fait. All right, and then your verb doesn't change. It is at the infinitive, construire, and the sentence ma maison continues. So, j'ai fait construire ma maison. So now we look at the negative form. I didn't have my house built. Je n'ai pas fait. And then construire ma maison. Remember, that's the way to put the negative form for the passé composé. So je n'ai pas fait. So once again, it's the verb faire at the passé composé, negative form. Then the rest, construire ma maison. Let's look at the futur proche. Remember this near future. It's interesting because you use the verb aller. Okay, so you end up with a sentence that is quite interesting. So I am going to have my house built. It's a bit heavy, we do agree, but still technically, grammatically, it's possible. So you end up with this structure, so je vais faire, because basically you will put this faire verb at this near future. So we construct it with aller, I am going to. Je vais faire and then construire ma maison. So of course if you look at the sentence it's a bit scary because you've got three verbs in a row, but still grammatically it's possible. Je vais faire construire ma maison. And so let's have a look now at the negative form of the same sentence. So I am not going to have my house built. Je ne vais pas faire construire ma maison. Okay, remember, negative form will impact the first verb, I mean the one conjugated. So je ne vais pas, and then faire construire ma maison. So let's look at the future simple, the real future. I will have my house built. Je ferai construire ma maison. So you can see that here it's the same concept. We still have faire, but then faire will be at the future simple. So it's conjugated. Je ferai, and then infinitive, construire ma maison. Well, negative form won't be really tricky. I will not have my house built. Je ne ferai pas construire ma maison. So let's see the conditionnel présent, and it's almost the same. I mean, phonetically, it's the same, but then remember, you need to put this S at the end of ferait. I would have my house built. Je ferai construire ma maison. And then the negative form. I would not have my house built. Je ne ferai pas construire ma maison. I hope you can master faire faire. Now, if it's not clear, watch the video one more time and then maybe do a few exercises to see if you master it.